why is this mad rush? You know, we were saying, why did this company have to say that people are leaving and moving to MNCs? What happened? Okay, what was the thing that changed the things for them? Okay, so why working with an MNC is the ultimate career goal for so many lawyers, and what is it that is really, really special, right? So let's roll that. Let's roll that. Yes. So that this is the number one thing, right? You know, your brand, it's a brand recognition. It's a name which everyone in the world has come across at some point of time. It is so it is spread over so many countries, okay? And it is so much of a regular name that people have come across that anybody recognizes this, right? Everyone understands or everyone knows this entity, right? So that is something that's a brand recognition. And this helps you further down the line. You know, brand recall helps you further down the line. How, like, you know, if you have had a background with an MNC and a name which everyone recognizes, naturally, when you are moving forward or you are changing positions, okay, people will recognize, people in similar positions or other MNCs will recognize this. So look at these changes here that we have brought, like, you know, Deepak Acharya moving from Procter & Gamble Singapore to Wipro, Gopi Krishnan moving from Infosys to WNS, Inderpreet Sawhney moving from Wipro to Infosys, Manjari Chowdhury moving from GE Power to Maruti Suzuki. So these are all, like, you know, in positions of general counsel and legal and compliance director, so senior positions like this. And they're all moving between MNCs, which are, like, you know, the other or larger MNCs, or maybe widespread, or maybe in a different zone to give them experience. Okay. Daimler to Cognizant, Welspun to Kraft Heinz. Okay, so these are all, like, moves or changes which will help you. So do you think when these guys were interviewed for their new positions, their background as Procter and Gamble, Infosys, Wipro, GE Power, these all things help them? Absolutely, right? Because these are the names which everyone knows of. Okay, and that's why people will believe that they have gone through a specific kind of experience, which will always help them in moving forward. Next slide, Yash. So definitely there is a bigger pay package and more perks. So it's one reason that, you know, or why people kind of move from the local entities to multinational companies. And there are reasons why multinational companies are able to do that. We'll see that as we progress. Okay, so MNCs will offer kind of 20 to 30 lakhs per annum for someone with a 3 years PQE. This can be, you know, a range of payment that people will get. And if you look at the domestic companies comparatively, okay, if they are hiring someone with a 3 years PQE, the range can be as wide as 7 to 20 lakhs. Okay, so it will be, like, you know, dependent upon the size, upon, you know, how you have been able to impress the interviewer and everything, but 7 to 20 lakhs is what you are likely to get. And this is not, like, you know, your 15, 20 years experience. This is like a 3 year PQE. So it will be very much someone who is getting from a beginner to a second zone, like a little movement from that. And this is what you get from the salary. So this is from Vahura and a March 2018 survey done by them. So they ask people, do you think that your salary is competitive? And 54% people in MNC said yes, while in the Indian entity, 65% said no. Okay. So this is the contrast you can see that you have, like, people are not very happy with what they are going to be paid, and that's the reason why they move from legal departments to MNCs.
And Komal, it is very important to remember that these are specific to legal counsels we are talking
Yeah,
about.
this
And
is
most importantly, when they talk about competitive.
so this is definitely there. You work in a very positive environment. There are some of the best places to work across industries, as in you don't find people breathing down your neck, shouting on you, disciplining you. These kind of things are very less likely, you know, showdowns in the middle of the in the aisle of the office, a Lewis lit kind of scenario. You will not face that in MNCs. Okay, so They beat, this is way back in 2016, but you can see like, you know, how the trend is. It's over 2016, it's continued over 2018. And if you look at what are the top companies to work for in India, where India wants to work now in 2019, you will see there are all MNCs, more or less all of them are multinational companies. Okay, so you can see it down like it's, and startups which have gone multinational, which have grown and which have become multinational. Flipkart is there, Amazon of course is there, OYO, and then you have, just go through the slides, yes, 197, which is Paytm, Uber. Okay, all of these are multinational entities. Okay, TCS is a multinational way, way back. Okay, Alphabet, of course, is multinational. Reliance. EY is an accounting firm, and still it's one of the best places to work for. So Adobe, of course, BCG, which is in management consulting, Yes Bank. These are all the entities that you have, which are like, you know, in the top gear for where people like to work. Okay, so one group or one category here are entities which are which have been multinational since a long period of time, like you know, IBM or Daimler or TCS. These have been in a multinational domain since a long while. And the other category is startups, which are now going multinational. And you will see this, like, you know, as a trend happening. We have been talking of this. So there's a trend that, you know, you will find startups expanding very, very quickly across the globe. Okay, because they want to take the benefit of that opportunity which is available to them. So immediately, they are not waiting to scale up. They are expanding across the globe, like very fast. Okay, let's move to the next one. So these are all entities. Like, as we said, there are lots of Indian startups going global. And we have in this, like, Cleartrip, Zomato. Cleartrip has a huge part of, like, you know, the GCC travel. It's like a travel aggregator, and it has a lot of customers over the GCC area. Okay, so it's a startup which is kind of like gone global. Zomato has gone global. So again, these are also in the good or the best places to work for, as you see. Okay, in addition to the ones that were traditionally multinational. Please move. Okay, Magster, you will see the reviews that these guys have. Again, just move. So you get an opportunity to work with really smart people. I completely, like, you know, subscribe to this. So you look at, like, you know, what is your relationship with your supervisor? Okay, this is with between a comparison between MNC and Indian. So many of them have said that it's a mentor-like situation. Okay, because these people are so senior, and the experience that I have had is that despite being in such a senior position, they are not of that, you know, they don't behave like, you know, you are something who is really irrelevant. Okay, they will mentor you, they will groom you, they will be polite, and they will respect the way that is works, because you can't have an MNC with, like, you know, culture which is really not working. That kind of reputation can spread very fast across the globe. So most cases you will see that they are either mentor-like or they are peer-like and collaborative. And then there is a very lower degree of people who are saying that, you know, they are authoritative, as compared to the Indian counterparts.